What's up, everybody? Welcome to the Lakers Nation postgame show. My name is Trevor Lane. Tough loss to the Orlando Magic. I'm sure you guys have a ton to say. I can't wait to talk to you guys about this one because I got a vent after that one. That was so frustrating to see the Lakers lose again to the Orlando Magic. Before we dive into everything, guys, make sure you check out our sponsors, Uptime Energy Drinks, Uptime How Energy Should Feel. Find them at GNC, 7-Eleven, and Amazon.com. And Fanatics, guys, head over to fanatics.com/LakersNation. You get a free shipping on top of everything else that they give you. They have all kinds of deals on there. Check it out, fanatics.com/LakersNation. You can get some sweet Lakers gear, kind of like this one, this LeBron jersey that I was able to pick up from Fanatics. Go check it out, fanatics.com/LakersNation. It's the holidays. Go grab your Lakers gear and make sure you support our show. All right, so here's how this is going to work. I'm going to be going through some things. I'm hoping that, not like the last show, my voice gives out. I'm hoping that my voice actually can stick around for an entire show here. I'm going to be taking your comments. I can't wait to hear what you guys have to say about this one because I know that Lakers Nation has a ton to say after such a difficult loss to the Magic. Let's run down some stats real quick. We've got a 108-104 win for the Magic. The Lakers dropped this game. Second time in about 8 days the Lakers have lost to the Orlando. This is a bad team, the Orlando Magic, right? This is a team that is not good, and they're one of the worst offensive teams in the league, but the Lakers found a way to lose to them twice here in a very short span. The guy doing most of the damage, Nikola Vucevic, again, 15 boards, 7 assists, 2 steals, 3 blocks, 31 points, hit 3 threes on the night. I had the Orlando feed, and the Orlando announcers were talking about how Vucevic could be making a push towards the All-Star game in the East. Man, if he keeps playing like this, he's an MVP candidate if he plays the Lakers every night, because he blows up every time he plays your Los Angeles Lakers. Part of that is I didn't like the way the Lakers were defending him in the first half. They were treating him as though he was a non-shooter, as though it was Tyson Chandler standing behind the three-point line or someone like that that just doesn't take threes. Vucevic has been a 40% three-point shooter on the season. You can't do that. So they allowed him to get going there. They did a terrible job helping whenever he drove to the basket. Guys weren't stepping over. And that's something I'm sure we're going to get into with your comments, is the help defense. So that was a big, big issue for the Lakers in today's game. I'm sure you guys have tons of questions. Again, I'm going to be reading through all of these comments kind of as we go. And if we get some good ones, we're going to be discussing them. So stick here with me and go ahead and fire away. Let me know what you guys think and what your thoughts are after what was obviously a very, very difficult loss. I'm going to start things off, though, by talking about the turnovers. That's an issue that has been becoming a bigger and bigger problem. So today, against the Orlando Magic, the Lakers had 18 turnovers, which is high. That's a lot. However, they had, I believe it was 14 in the first half. And that's really, really bad. Yeah, 14 turnovers in the first half. So only 4 turnovers in the second half. So they cleaned things up, and that's what eventually allowed them to claw their way back in after a terrible shooting third quarter. But those turnovers in the first half took a game that should have been a blowout. The Lakers were playing so much. They should have had a 20-plus point lead at halftime. But because of the turnovers, the Orlando Magic, even though they were shooting in the high 30s from the field, the Lakers were in the mid-50s, the Magic got so many more looks because the Lakers kept turning the ball over. So they had fired up a lot more shots than the Lakers had. And that was also a problem against the Utah Jazz, another game that should have been an easier win than it really was. So the turnovers are becoming a problem for this Lakers team for a few reasons. First of all, you have a game here where if they turn the ball over less, they probably win it. And even in the games that they do win, they're turning the ball over so much that it's taking a blowout game and making it a close game. And when you do that, you're denying rest to guys like LeBron James. He's had to play in the fourth quarter of every single game. So that's going to be a problem. And guys, as we go, I'm going to have to stop and take a drink here and everything because I'm still not 100%. But I got my uptime energy, and hopefully I can power through. let's see. LeBron didn't finish it. That's why the Lakers lost. I'm seeing a few comments on that. Make free throws. Yes. Fabio Baduin says make free throws. Yeah, from the line, they were 20 of 31, 64%. And it was actually much worse than that through most of the game. That's not good. that's going to be a problem. That's something that's, there's going to be an ebb and flow there, but overall the Lakers have not been a great free throw shooting team. As I, last I looked, they were about 25th in the NBA. That's not going to get it done. David Sanford said, trade for that center. He is on an expiring deal, so it will be interesting to see if Vucevic does get moved. But, man, yeah, he's looked really good whenever he plays the Lakers. Again, excuse me, guys, for the uptime energy drink, but it's how I'm going to get through this because I've been sick and haven't been able to be at full strength here. let's see. Luke Walton rotations are nonsense. Nate Buzelli. Guys, what do you think? I've seen a lot of comments here. We saw no Lonzo Ball down the stretch. So what are we thinking about KCP finishing out the game? I kind of get what Luke was going for. It was a defense-first thing, and I thought that KCP was making some things happen defensively. But Lonzo is a good defender himself. You look at what he did this game. He played 29 minutes, which is still a lot. I mean, he played plenty, but 10 boards, right? I mean, you need that. I thought he was playing pretty well defensively, but maybe Luke just liked what KCP was doing in the switch situations. That that was something that was definitely helpful. Oh, I hope I can make it through this, guys. I'm going to do everything I can here. So what else do we have? shooting way too many. Zach Whitlow says the Lakers are shooting way too many threes in general, and certain guys need to be more consistent. Let me see. Because they were down in threes quite a bit. Well, they fired up 26 total in the game. In the first half, they'd only shot like five. So they fired up a lot in the second half, and that certainly helped them. And they actually shot 38%. They're actually one of the better three-point shooting teams in the league, which wasn't the case early and wasn't something that we expected out of this team. But you know what? They were able to – they've been able to start making them. So that's been pretty good. I think it's something that's been helping them. So I don't necessarily think the threes were bad. Alex Lang says, KCP fights through screens, the hardest of any team, but his shot was off today. Yeah, 1-for-7 shooting from KCP was not great. Caesar Angelo says, Josh Hart is better than KCP. Here's the thing. So Josh Hart, I want you guys to watch this. If you go back and watch the game again, watch Josh Hart's mobility. It's non-existent. Notice, in fact, I think he didn't even take a shot. Let me see. Yeah, 15 minutes, no shots for Josh Hart. The reason for that is because he has an injured ankle, and he actually hurt it a couple games ago, and he was questionable in the previous game and still played, but obviously he's not 100%. He played today, but again, he's not – Josh Hart taking no shots in 15 minutes is weird. That's a clear indication that he is not 100%. So I get playing KCP over Josh Hart right now because Josh Hart just doesn't have it. He doesn't, right? And that's okay. He's injured. He's still out there giving what he can. But it's a big blow to the Lakers in terms of their spacing because Josh Hart have been statistically their best three-point shooter. What else do you guys have here? Svi should not be in the game before Zoe. Tom Stew throws that one out there. Svi got minutes because Luke Walton was out of ideas, basically. He's trying to get someone in there that can spark some energy for the team, and they just didn't have it. And so why not throw Svi out there and see if he can get something going? Tommy Cortez says, I want to see Mo Wagner play. Probably not the game for him because of how good Vucevic was playing. But, yeah, I think eventually Mo Wagner can get some minutes for them. Another thing that I want to get into, the defense. Let's talk about that a little bit. So LeBron James, and I know a lot of you are frustrated with LeBron's defense. And it wasn't just him. But there were multiple plays where his man, I think of two specifically in the third quarter, one being Aaron Gordon and one being Jonathan Isaac, cut, not a backdoor cut, not a backside cut, cut right in front of him to the rim, and he didn't react. And it wound up with, you know, with easy baskets at the rim. And LeBron gets caught ball watching on defense. You can see where he doesn't put in that effort. And you know what? On one hand, you want to take a step back and say, hey, it's LeBron James. He knows what he needs to do in order to be productive on the offensive end, in order to make it through a full NBA season. He's been doing this for 16 years now. Back off, give him slack. But at the same time, it's frustrating when you see simple basketball things that he should be doing on the defensive end that are effort-based that aren't happening. It's still hard to see that happen. let's see what else we've got here. And, you know, overall defensively, I wasn't pleased with the Lakers. I thought they started well and finished well defensively, but overall wasn't good, especially second and third quarter defense. Ahmed Hussein Al-Baz says our free throw percentage today. Yeah, like I said, our free throw shooting was terrible. Free throw shooting 20 of 31 from the line. Getting to the line 31 times, hey, you'll take that. That's great. But only shooting 64% there. LeBron 6 of 11. Ouch. LeBron, I mean, still, for the game, LeBron finishes with 24 points, 7 assists, 4 boards, 2 threes, 8 of 14 shooting. Just the 6 of 11 from the line kind of hurts there. That's not great. Let me see what else you guys have. I'm sure you have tons of comments. Is an excuse to not talk about it. Yeah, let's talk about that. Okay, so Michael Donald White says LeBron not shooting well from the free throw line isn't an excuse not to talk to attack the basket at the other end. So the final play, or the big play, LeBron's got the ball. And I want to get into this in a second, the Lakers going ISO, because that's something we absolutely need to talk about, one of my pet peeves. But at the end, you've got LeBron attacking the basket. He goes into Nikola Vucevic. Everybody thought, here it comes, tomahawk dunk. LeBron's going to just go up and slam it over him. And instead, he kicks it out to KCP, who misses a three. That hurt. Yes, I would like to see LeBron just go ahead and take that shot. I know a lot of you probably would as well. You'd be hoping that LeBron would go ahead and shoot that. I think in the moment, he felt like he had a tough look. He saw KCP open. KCP had hit one earlier. Figured why not throw it out to him. I get what he was thinking there, but again, that's where you'd rather see LeBron go strong, go through him, maybe get the end one, get to the line. I think he's got to have that confidence that he's going to make the free throws, even if he's missed a bunch in that game, because that's him. That's what he's got to do for this Lakers team. He's got to be able to hit those free throws. And so that was an issue. And then the other thing that I want to talk about, of course, was going ISO. So this Lakers team, they excel when they can get out and run, right? They excel when they can get out in transition, when they can get defensive stops. But towards the end of games, if they have a lead or if a game is close, they slow it down, they look for the half-court offense, and they give the ball to LeBron, and they spread the floor. And you see that every single time. The Magic did not do that. The Magic didn't go ISO. The Magic actually ran some plays, had some guys cutting, got a decent look for Terrence Ross. We basically put the nail in the coffin. Why not run a play? Why not do something rather than just go ISO every single time? I think slow it down basketball is not what this team can do. Their half-court offense is just frankly not good enough to rely on it to be able to just take your foot off the gas, throw it into a half-court set, and then expect to get a bucket. It's usually not happening. Yeah, you're running down the shot clock and you're wasting time, but you're missing the shot almost every time. Again, excuse me for those guys who are just tuning in. I'm fighting a cold, so I'm trying to keep my throat going here. But when you do that, you take your offense kind of out of a rhythm, and that's something that this Lakers team actually had going for them. They had some momentum going. So to completely switch that strategy when the game's on the line, not a fan. I'd like to see them actually run a play in that situation. I think that would be a lot better to go to long term. It's something I'd like to see a little bit more. Sergio Vizcarra said, use Beasley over Svi. Beasley, we haven't seen Beasley in a long time, have we? Michael Beasley, he's on a 1-year deal. And somebody tweeted, and I wish I could remember who it was, but somebody tweeted that Beasley during a timeout, the entire Lakers team is huddled up, and Beasley was across the court giving Chris Bosh a hug. Yeah. That's not a great sign. Coaches aren't going to like that. So if you're wondering why Beasley's not in, that's probably part of it. He's probably been told that he isn't going to be in. All right. final comments so I can get out of here and take some cold meds and everything. What do you guys think? Lakers, next game, take on the Denver Nuggets. Going to be a tough one. It's a rival game at the Nuggets. The Nuggets always play the Lakers tough. It's tough to play in Denver. And this is a budding rivalry. I mean, the hate for Jamal Murray is real. And that's something that Lakers fans are starting to feel. I'm excited for this game. But if the Lakers play like they did today, they're in big trouble because that Nuggets team is very, very good. So what do you guys think? Can they get a win? I'm interested to hear what you guys have to say on that. But we've got another comment. Trade KCP and Ingram for Beal. Guys, we went over this last time. I talked all about it. Actually, it was two shows ago. Talked all about why that doesn't make sense in terms of cap space. And if you do that, you're ruining your shot at, say, a Kevin Durant because you won't have that max salary slot anymore. So, yeah, that's not a good thing. I don't think the Lakers will go ahead and do that. And I don't think that Beal is the guy that's going to really put them over the top. Jesse Gomez says, Zoe should have been playing in the fourth. Get that. Yeah, I mean, I agree. I think that you should have given Zoe some minutes there. But could see why Luke went with KCP. Again, excuse me. We'll wrap up in just a minute. I'm hanging in there for you guys here. Let's see. Your final thoughts here. They'll win if LeBron doesn't lollygag, Zach Whitlow says. Attack the rim and draw fouls. Agreed. If you get full effort out of LeBron, I think they can win. Steven Rodriguez, KCP and Ingram for Devin Booker. I don't think the Phoenix Suns are going to move Devin Booker, who's also on a huge deal. All right, guys. Lakers take on the Denver Nuggets next. We'll be back. We'll do another post-game show. I'll have Jas Kang for that one, so I won't have to talk the entire time and blow through my voice again. I'm hoping by then I'll finally be healthy, but this thing is just lingering, and it's killing me. I hate this. I want to be able to just go for half an hour talking Lakers basketball with you guys because I have all these thoughts that I'd love to go over with you. But all that being said, thank you, everybody, for tuning in. Make sure you guys head over to 7-Eleven, GNC, and Amazon.com. Grab some Uptime energy drinks. And, of course, Fanatics.com/LakersNation. Pick up your Lakers gear. We'll be back. We'll do this again after the next game against the Denver Nuggets. So make sure you check back right here. Love getting all of your comments. Certainly appreciate it, guys. My name's Trevor Lane. You can follow me on Twitter at Trevor_Lane. I can tweet things a lot better than I can talk right now because my voice is gone. But, yeah, guys, make sure you head over to LakersNation.com, your home for everything Lakers. Get all the news going on in the world of the Los Angeles Lakers and what's been going on with this team. You're going to get all the great post-game quotes and everything you need right there at LakersNation.com. So go check it out, and thank you again for tuning in today, and we'll see you next time.